Star students, मैं रूपम गुप्ता आई एम ट्राइंग टू हेल्प यू आउट इन दिस पैंडमिक सिचुएशन टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पीरियडिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट वाई टू क्लासीफाई द एलिमेंट्स हाउ टू क्लासीफाई द एलिमेंट्स एंड वॉट आर द वेरियस मोड्स ऑफ क्लासीफिकेशन नाउ आर नेक्स्ट टारगेट इज टू फाइंड आफ्टर क्लासीफाइंग देम वेयर डू दे एग्जिस्ट Do they exist means where do the elements exist? In which position? Position like we are giving their home address. Where are they existing? Where are they residing? In the periodic table. Like if I'll ask you, what is your residential address? You also tell like 42A, Hardey Colony or near this. And as some landmarks also you tell. Similarly, what is the residential address of the elements? In the scientific term, we say position of elements. In which group, in which period they are existing. To which period and group they belong. And it is not typical science. It is simple mathematics. Simple calculations. As we will begin with the simplest element, hydrogen. You all are aware. And in the previous class, atomic numbers we have discussed in class 9 you have done this so hydrogen is a first atomic number and electron number will be always same with the atomic number so electrons will also be one and we have discussed electronic configuration in these four shells kl mn and we can put the numbers also 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 shells. Okay. One electron only, and we know that in K shell, two electrons can be filled. So one is the configuration. Okay. Take example of 11th atom, which is sodium. Electrons, as you know, will also be 11 only. And in these 11 electrons, if we need to fill the electronic configuration, so K shell, definitely 2 electrons, the maximum possibility. L shell, maximum 8 we can fill. How many are left? 2 and 8, 10. So the 11th electron is only left. So the 11th electron will be filled in the M shell. One more example for your easy understanding. Suppose 20th element I am choosing, calcium. Definitely 20 electrons and the configuration will be 2, 8, 8, 2. Okay, this I hope you all know that in advance. Still, I repeat for your conveniency, hydrogen 1 electron, configuration 1, sodium 11 electron, configuration 2, 8, 1, calcium 20 electrons, configuration 2, 8, 8, 2 as per the octet rule which we have already discussed in class 9th. And for knowledge, repeat, in K shell maximum electrons to be filled 2, in L shell 8, in M shell also 18, in N 32. So this which we are discussing is for 1 to 20 elements only about configuration and everything. Even the position of elements we can discuss by this method for 1 to 20 elements. See how can we discuss? Properly focus here, what am I writing? As you all know, valence electrons are very important. They play an important role. They decide the valency of the atom. They decide the chemical properties of the atom, that how many electrons will react. And this time also, position of the elements will also be decided by only the valence electron. How? See, valence electron, they are in which shell number will decide for us what is the period number of that particular element. So simple it is. Okay, and now if I want to know the group number, like in which group do they exist, in that case we have to check number of valence electron. See, this is the rule. The simplest trick to find out valence electron is in which shell, that number of the shell explains us the period number. And how many valence electrons are present, that is presented by group number. Okay, so So this is so easy, and let us apply it to this. Where is the valence electron? Definitely this. Valence means outermost electron. So this is the outermost electron. This is the outermost electron. This is the outermost electron. I hope you all have understood it. Okay. Now with this, we want to know period number and group number. So let us find it out. Check. Shell number tells us period number. Shell number 1. Check, valence electron is in which shell? First. So period number 1. Easy. Valence electron which shell? Third. So period number 3. Valence electron which shell? Fourth. So period number 4th. Isn't it so easy? Okay. Let us check group number now. What will we do in the group? Number of valence electron tells us group number. So how many valence electron? 1. So group number will also be 1. Okay. How many valence electrons? Again 1. So group number will be 1. Okay. How many valence electrons? 2. So this time group number will be 2. Fine. One more example. Suppose I have chosen 5th element. What is it? Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron. So boron is the 5th element. Electrons will also be 5. I know now you are able to write the configuration also. Very easy. 2, 3. Easily you can tell the period number. There is no doubt about it. Because the valence electron which shell? 2nd. So period number will be 2. What is about group number? How many valence electrons? 3. So group number will be 3. No, wait. In this case group number will not be 3. Because you see, if valence electrons are 1 and 2, in that case first group and second group. But when the number exceeds from 2, like 3 and so on, we need to do plus 10. I'll tell you the reason also, but first you understand it mathematically. Repeating, focus here. 1 valence electron, first group. 2 valence electron, second group. But if it exceeds from 2, like 3, 4, 5, this way, so we need to add plus 10. Apply this knowledge here. How many valence electrons? 3 exceeded from 2. We had to do plus 10. And if we are doing plus 10, that means boron belongs to 13th group. Okay. Similarly, if I am choosing the configuration of suppose 2, 8, 7, which is chlorine, 17th number and 17th electron. So now you know that valence electron is this. To which period they will belong? 3rd period, no doubt in that. And group number, how many valence electrons? 7 valence electrons. See, exceeded from 2, that means plus 10. And if you do plus 10, that means group number will be 17. Easy. Now you can practice for any element which is in the range of 1 to 20 elements. Is that okay? I hope now this method is very tricky and very easy for you to find out the position of the elements in the periodic table. Like where do they exist? To which period do they belong? To which group do they belong? And this simple method will help you to know. Okay, so, and what is the reason to do this plus 10? Why have we not like 3rd group, 4th group? This we are going to discuss in our next video. So don't forget to see the next video to know this knowledge, that why do we added or why do we need to add that plus 10. Thank you so much, children. I hope you have understood.